Hello YouTube and welcome back to my channel for some more Samurai Warriors 4-2. So previously we have left off with, of course, the story mode on the chapter of Master and Servants, and as well as the other completed chapters. So today we're going to start a new campaign, which is also featuring a new character from 4, our good old Uesugi Kagekatsu. Let's get ready for this, people. We are starting the chapter of the generations. Alright then. Is it like a trend or something? Basically, the intro for each campaign is getting progressively shorter. So we are introduced with a game that we haven't played for a while, the Tenshojingo Riot, which is up against... I don't even remember who it was, but we're fighting alongside Tokugawa. So it is going to be a 3-star battle out of 10. Let's see what is going to happen, shall we?
方の王子を包囲。天使公の後を追し、影勝様の救援を今かと待っております。しかし父上、武田のみならず影虎様との戦いで傷つきし、上杉の領土まで侵食するとは国に許されませんな。影虎、申し上げません。
王子様をはじめ城内の皆々様ご自害。間に合いませんでしたか。申し上げます。突如王子城をより撤退。不可解な影勝様、いかに。織田を追撃する。はっ。
上杉景勝は父上杉謙信の死後に起きた上杉家当主となった。景勝が当主となってすぐに上杉に最大の危機が訪れる。上杉領の越中が天下の織田軍の侵攻を受けたのである。勢いに勝る織田軍の前に 上杉軍は徐々に後退。王子城が落とされたことで、景勝は越中の支配権を失う。だが本能寺で織田信長が討たれると状況は一変。織田軍は越中から撤退する。景勝は越中の支配権回復に努める一方、信長の死後空白地となった 信濃の地に狙いを定める。同じく空白地を狙う北条や、それに従う真田に抗するため、徳川軍と組み、四勢力が入り乱れる領土争いに参戦した。太樹の将、
ありがとうございました。
影勝様の手足となりましょう。
Oh wow, now that was what it was all about. I was like, I played this game, and I was like, not game, but battle. I'm like, where did I play it? And why is it like featuring, I guess, Tokugawa, but I just can't remember it. Now I remember, this is like, I guess, right after the whole incident in Honnoji, so that's why, I guess, during the course, even though Oda is actually attacking, I guess, Uesugi, but because he, like, the news of him being, I guess, killed in action during the Honnoji incident had the Oda army have, like, everyone retreated, so it gives them a, I guess, space to actually, well, first of all, space to actually breathe, take a breath after all the serious warfare in between Oda as well as the, I guess, the border, eastern part of Japan, as in the regions where Echigo, I guess, family of Uesugi was based off at, and of course, and during course, they could actually help to take out, I guess, the, like I mentioned in the previous battle, in full range, the pesky Hojo family. I'm not saying they're pesky in a bad way, it's just like, you know, sometimes if you want to be a preacher, be a, I guess, thought provoker, there's a lot of different methods of using, like, I guess, persuasion or manipulation on people, but just what they've been putting on propaganda and just, like, trying to promote is just, you know, it's kind of, like, false, I guess, commercial. It's like, oh, we are the nicest people ever. We treat our, I guess, subjects like our family. We love our family, so therefore, treat like for us, fight against people that we can clearly not defeat. And, okay, so the, like, in the, I guess, the 1 or 2 minute, I don't even know how long, the little narration before each battle, it's said that because during the course of, I guess, the clash of Nobunaga and all the other, I guess, powers, Uesugi Kenshin passed away due to sickness, and the Uesugi family went into, I guess, a successor battle in between him, as well as, I guess, the adopted son from the Hojo family. So, because they actually have a member of the family who was an adopted son that originally was the son of, I guess, Hojo Uesugi. So, I guess the storyline would eventually have some clash in between, I guess, the Hojo family leftovers and, like, Uesugi family, like, right now. This battle also had the, I guess, Hojo family featured, but I remember Hojo family didn't just die off that soon. There's still the Odawara, like, city siege, so I think I would be expecting this campaign to feature a lot of, I guess, clashes with the Hojo family and what's left of it. And speaking of which, because there is a campaign that actually featured, I guess, Miss Righteousness, so it's not very unexpected for me to actually, hey, I know where I've seen this battle, well, probably because it's gonna be one of the almost closely mirrored action type of campaign. Going back to, I guess, generally speaking, I don't remember, am I, but I'm pretty sure I did mention about how the Uesugi family originally is not named the Uesugi family. I think it's like the Nagao family, but they were given, I guess, the surname of Uesugi after they, well, I don't remember that being so badass before. I know it's a big attack and very powerful, but, like, that extent, or it's just the camera, I think, for that particular moment was pretty epic, so yeah. Yeah, like all, I guess, Power Class characters, our boy here very sluggish movement, but, you know, like, sluggish doesn't mean that. Yeah. Speaking of which, we have just completed Daki Masamune and Katakura Kojuro's campaign. FYI, which I don't know how many people actually does give a crap about, the voice actor in Japanese for Uesugi Kagekatsu as well as Kakakura Kojudo are the same person. It's Takeuchi Ryota, which is a very cool dude with awesome daydreams like I do and very talented singing apparently. So yeah, moving on. So their family originally are called the Nagao family, which is also a famous, I guess, a military family of generals and politicians. And they have done a lot of, I guess, improvements in their areas, was very strong in any warfare. So eventually they were given, I think one of those Kanto generals surname from the history, like, not just the surname, though. For Kenshin himself, he was actually, I think, given the whole name of Uesugi Kenshin, because Uesugi Kenshin is the, I guess, the full name of the, I guess, the Kanto general, like, head of generals, I guess, title. So, therefore, like, I guess from that onwards, they actually just inherited the surname of the Uesugi family. And going back to... Yup. Yeah, the Hojo people, I'm pretty sure we're gonna have a little clash with each other, and it's not even gonna be fun, because... speaking of the clash though, so during the, I guess, Battle of the Successors, obviously from the perspective of the game is like, this guy, like Kagekatsu, really just want to carry on and finish what, I guess, Kenshin left undone, and just support the Uesugi family. But it's not because Kagetora, which is I think the youngest son of Ujiyasu, after a particular war lost to the Uesugi family, so they ended up as a, I guess, part of the peace treaty. They let their son become the, I guess, adopted son of Kenshin. Just as you know, if he already had a son, why does he want a second one? Well, because his first son technically is not his, it's his sister's son. He, from, I guess, like most of the historical references, is unmarried and died of a young, not really young age, but not that old compared to our standards right now, because, you know, like, we have a lot of 80 years old and above people, so back then, we're 50, we just like, but then the problem is, Kagekatsu knows what's the deal. If you let dispute, like, civil dispute within the clan and the, I guess, the nation itself, to carry on, it's not gonna be beautiful. Like, it's gonna be doing more harm to, I guess, the long run, as well as the people who live in it in general, than just, I guess, taking out one of us and end this for all. So this is another thing of, I guess, it's like a norm of the warring states, or any chaotic, I guess, war-torn like eras and regions of, I guess, humanity history. So you can't really blame him to be like, okay, so I had to take you out. It's not like, oh, because you used to be a Hojo, I'm just gonna kill your ass. No, it doesn't work that way. So I guess Uesugi is not most famously, well, I guess, known for the fact that they're actually one of the sworn, I guess, enemy of the Hojo family. They're actually known for the fact that they're sworn enemies with the Takeda family. Like the original, I guess, the shogun that Yukimura's family worked for, Takeda Shingen. Yeah, like one of them, like Takeda Shingen, was actually named as, I think it's like Kai's tiger, and then Uesugi Kenshin is Ichigo's dragon. So these two beasts are very ferocious, according to mythology and I guess the beliefs of ancient Japanese people. They are almost of the same class, that's why they can clash against each other, and they have eternally been rivals of each other. But then, for some reason, both of them actually died of illness in almost the same era, almost the same age, actually. But like I've said, not everyone's successor could be a very useful person to carry on with, I guess, the first generation left off. Speaking of generations, though, the reason why I actually name this campaign as the Campaign of Generations is because it's called Taizu no Sho. Taizu actually means a big old tree. If had I named this as the tree chapter, it sounds ridiculous because Taizu in Asian culture, as well as if you decipher the kanji in general, it actually means like the supportive characters. Like, I guess the, like, you know, like backstage people. And then from what I could interpret from the whole scenario, like the introduction and stuff, it's more like he is the next generation. But he knows that, like, in order to bring complete unity and peace to the war in Japan, he's not gonna be exactly the one to do it. So it either means that he's the next generation of working out peace for the well-being of Japanese people, or maybe he's going to, I guess, bring up and support the new generations. All in all, I really don't know what is going to happen in this campaign, because for some reason, maybe it's just because he is known for, like, even in history as well as the game, he's known for being a quiet person. So whatever he's done in 4, as well as, I guess, his own existence in general, even in, I guess, Chronicles 3, I don't have much recollections about this character. Although I know he's very cute, because he, whenever he does talk, though, it's like a, I guess, an awkwardly cute conversation. Like, he's very, I guess, timid. Like, he's not the type of, like, sharpest person, although he's very intelligent, so. Okay. The group Musou totally failed like crap, because I forgot that our boy, Naoe Kanetsugu, actually does not move a big, I guess, area after he initiated his attack. So the only damage is done is only by my character, so luckily I have the plus attack, I guess, boost in my skills, or else it's gonna be, I guess, seriously. Oh my god, camera angles are even more intensive than normal Musou. The camera angles, though, I really wish they could patch this. I haven't turned on the internet PlayStation for a long time, because I have weird messages popping at me all of a sudden. And although you say, like, privacy, you can switch it on and off. First of all, I'm lazy. Second of all, I don't remember how to do that anymore, so it's just like, eh. So I just turned off the internet, ignoring those people. But going back to the game, all in all, though, it's pretty, I guess, decent. Like, up to this point, we're more than, I guess, 70% done with this game. It's pretty good. You just have to admit that. Although a lot of things are repetitive, but then the story-wise, and some of the characters' dialogue-wise, it actually brings a lot of, I guess, freshness to the, I guess, franchise. Going back to Naoe Kanetsugu, he's, like, a lot of people who actually know a little bit of kanji, regardless if you're Asian or not, would be like, holy crap, man, he's one of those, like, old-school person who actually put the word love on his helm. Why do you think he's designed it like that? Well, unfortunately for, I guess, Naoe Kanetsugu, his fashion sense is turned, because that is exactly what he wore in, like, almost 600, well, not really, it's just 500 years ago during the Warring States. He was famous for his, like, helmet to have the literally stenciled, like, the character I love, like, on his head. So they're not trying to destroy this character by making him look funky and stupid. It's not even stupidity. It's just that's how he was known by the, I guess, the later generations of us. So, for some reason, I don't know why, like, Tenshojingo, although we're facing after Ozo Ujiyasu, but apparently on top of his head it doesn't say boss. It doesn't say boss. What do you mean it doesn't say? Jesus, my driver, man. Okay, like, I have to just wake up, because for some reason it's 8:31 at night in Hong Kong, and I'm just so sleepy. I didn't wake up early this morning either, so it's kind of weird. I didn't eat a lot before my dinner, so I shouldn't be having, like, digestion cause drowsiness. For some reason, I just, like, I could concentrate on the game, though, but not really in the sense that I actually could commentate without making stupid grammatical mistakes and, I guess, pronunciation. Whoa! See, folks, like I've said, every single time when I start a new campaign, I have to at least once go into a clutch, like, situation where my HP becomes in the critical red. Because Mr. future family of Ujiasu is just being a total D-bag, okay? There you go. STFU and GTFO. How's about that? So yeah, basically, I don't know, calling it the generations maybe just make it sound cool, or can't you for people to actually decide to click for it when I put it up in, I guess, title of the video. I have no idea, because if you do literal translation though, for real though, it's just ridiculous, because it's like the chapter of the tree, and you're like, what the fuck, what does it have to do with the tree? Trust me, even though I haven't finished this, I just started this campaign, I don't even know what's gonna fucking happen. I'm pretty sure whatever the fuck that's gonna happen in the Warring States era, it's not gonna be about trees, okay? It's not gonna be like all going like WWF and all eco friendly and this shit, okay? So, no worries about that. And yeah, so the people, I guess, leaders, skeptics will be like, hey, why do you think this chapter the Master and Servant? Because technically, should you need Master and Servant, employee and employee? That is their situation. There's nothing you can actually change about that. So, although it is an extremely long-ass campaign or scenario, maybe you just have to name it that way, because obviously there is no completely perfect translation, that I know for sure, but you just have to make sure for like majority of the audience who are not familiar with the Japanese culture and language, at least would understand the rationale behind why the developers actually named particular campaign that way. And all in all, it could also help you decide, hey, do I really dislike this game? Maybe I want this game too. Oh my lord. Yeah, now I know why I remember Tenshojingo. It's because it was in the, I think, the family affair Uesugi battle. It's either in the family affair Jingo battle or it was in the Rising Stars. Which I'm pretty sure is going to be family because probably this is gonna be like the battle that is the first clash between like Nobuyuki and Kimura, I'm not sure. But all in all, maybe I remember incorrectly, maybe I'm just too drowsy. We have now completed the first battle of the campaign of the generations. And shit, I was planning to use the main character. Oh, now I know why he's the boss. It's gonna go on with the, I guess, the Justice Trio thingamajiggy, like the whole thing that they've been trying to advertise on since, I guess, 2 and 3. I think it's like 2 Extreme Legends after the introduction of Mitsunari. So, why is it being emphasized in this? Probably is because of what I possibly suggested the generations. Like, he's gonna foresee the change of the world. The change in Uesugi family as well as the change of those around him. I'm not sure yet, but let's find out.
あなた方は私の首を取りに来たのですか。いいな。わしは真田幸村。敵ながらそのまっすぐな戦ぶり、義にあふれた振る舞いに影勝様は感動したとのことだ。うん。また会おう、幸村。
影勝殿に
金継殿か。Alright, well then, we have a slight difference actually in this particular battle compared to the one that we've done before. So the next one, without doubt, is one of the most overly played battle, Komaki Nagakute. So I don't know what is gonna go down in this version, but let's find out in the next battle together. Bye!